Deinze in Belgium. Thomas van der Plaetsen is back on the track training for the World University Games. After several months of absence from the international scene, the decathlete is enjoying the most important victory of his life. The Universiade winner of Kazan has defeated the cancer that was detected last September.
I feel good knowing where I'm coming from, but I can't say I'm completely like the old Thomas Decathlon athlete yet, but I'm getting closer and closer every week, so. And I'm glad to be on the track, like going for a goal, but I'm realistic in saying that I'm not completely in top shape yet. Guangzhou was, I think, perfect timing. It was a challenge because it was not a lot of time to get ready, but it was also something I was looking forward to defend my title. It's the last straight line, so I mean, this is, I leave in 2 weeks, so we're just trying to get my body competition ready and ready for a full decathlon, so which is going to be very hard. So we're trying to just up the intensity in training and make sure that I recover from day to day.
The Athletics Cup of Deinze gives Thomas the best conditions to work on his recovery. Coached by his brother Michael, a former decathlete himself, Thomas is working hard, preparing for the upcoming Summer Universiade. Two daily training sessions are programmed, and Thomas is progressing despite some ups and downs.
He wants to come back better than he was before. I think he has a lot of potential, but we take it step by step. It's very hard to predict where we're going to be in the next 6 months.
At the beginning of the year, Thomas went to South Africa to build his body up again. It's his favorite country. He's trained there for several years. Mentally, he rediscovered himself too, supported by his brother and local training partners.
We started in January, quite quickly after the chemotherapy. And in the beginning, the physical part was really hard. So running, I remember he would do like a jog 400 meters around the track, and that was it. It was finished.
As soon as he started doing a bit more high intensity training, he started having some low days, and I could see mentally he started just dropping down. And you've just got to be there for him, you know. You've just got to say, listen, this is normal. You had a serious illness. I mean, it's expected with this type of training, but your body will adjust. You will get over it.
Because I wanted to move forward, and I obviously had this picture in mind of preparing for the university games and going forward every week, but it felt like for 2 months I wasn't going anywhere. I think the last few weeks I'm starting to really put that behind me, and now training is becoming something more enjoyable again.
Thomas's world had fallen apart on the 3rd of September last year. He underwent an anti-doping test at home. At the time, he was preparing his ambitious Road to Rio program. 3 weeks later, he got the results of the test.
I came home after training and I saw a letter on the table stating that I had tested positive for HCG, which was, which blindsided me completely because I had no clue where it came from. So obviously that was a very big shock to me, and it set in motion a series of events that changed my life completely.
Thomas simply couldn't understand how HCG, a hormone associated with pregnancy, could be in his body. He protested his innocence, insisting that he'd never taken any doping substances.
So we immediately knew there was another problem. And so we researched the internet, and we were trying to find more information on the hormone that Thomas tested positive on. And we concluded fairly quickly that It probably was cancer because we knew he didn't take any drugs. So the only other option was cancer. So we called up his doctor and the next day we found out he had cancer.
But in the meantime, the media were headlining his positive test, ignoring the fact that 24 hours later, he learned that he had testicular cancer. HCG can be excreted by some tumors, including testicular cancers.
Thomas had never tested positive before. He had no abnormal values. And I think he should have gotten the benefit of the doubt.
That's something that, as an athlete, you never want to have happen to you in your life. I was lucky in the sense that I knew that my name was going to get cleared quite fast because of the medical condition. But yeah, it's very hard to just get everything you've built up over the years. Like, I mean, I have an honest reputation. I've always been open with everyone, and I've always been a very hardworking athlete. And just to have that reputation and that whole image of yourself, just see it slashed to the ground by one single article about doping is something that you cannot imagine as an athlete.
At the European Championships, Thomas had finished 10th in the decathlon, winning the high jump discipline along the way. Now he was facing surgery and heavy chemotherapy, fighting the hardest battle of his life.
He was one of the best athletes in the world. And then just a few months later on, he's losing all his body weight, he's losing his hair, he's feeling sick, he's throwing up. And it's been pretty tough on him.
2014 had been a good year for Thomas van der Plaetsen. He'd won bronze at the World Cup indoor event at Sopot in Poland. In doing so, he set a new Belgian record. Now, he refused to let the cancer get him down.
It's very hard to cope with at first, but I think I took peace with it quite quickly and realized that I just had to put my energy into coming back and into getting healthy again. I'm sure I'll get back to that level and then be able to dream again of winning medals.
A year earlier, back in July 2013, the Summer Universiade in Kazan, Thomas van der Plaetsen took the gold medal in the decathlon. He'd been struggling with a serious injury. Now, he was back at the top.
It wasn't an easy competition. The circumstances weren't ideal. So I was very glad to pull through and actually get that win after having struggled for over a year with injuries.
Thomas chose the decathlon because he loves challenges. At Ostrava in 2011, he won the under-23 European Championships, demonstrating his talent in the competition over a period of 2 days.
I just love the stress and I love the tension and the motivation it gives me to perform. And like, I mean, it's an environment I thrive in. And I think that's something that has set me apart in the past and that'll hopefully keep serving me in the future.
Thomas knows how to adapt to the humid heat of Guangzhou in the summertime, and he's preparing to defend his title down to the finest detail. His personal best is 8,255 points, and he's hoping to get close to that figure again in the University Games.
I would love to score over 8,000 points in the decathlon. That's kind of an ambitious goal to say 6 months after getting cancer treatment to say, like, I want to get 8,000 again. But it's something that motivates me.
Thomas van der Plaetsen sets an example for everybody, showing that there is hope, showing a fighting spirit. And he's ready for Guangzhou, not as a cancer patient, but as an athlete once more. Coming up on Campus Sport, the fantastic vaulter, Yang Haxun. And three other Universiade champions with a story worth telling.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
The International University Sports Federation brings together millions of students worldwide around the same values: excellence in mind and body. Thousands of students, hundreds of universities participate in FISU events, the rendezvous for the best student athletes. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.